festival has pre-Christian roots. It coincides with Samhain, the Celtic commemoration of the end of the light half of the year and the coming of the dark. In Welsh, this night is called Nos Galangaeaf, the night of the calends of winter, and it begins at sunset on October 31st. For the pre-Christian Celts, this was the new year, when sacred fires consumed the past and illuminated the present, and when the departed were believed to draw near. It was a time when the doors to the west were left open to welcome the beloved dead, and a candle left in the western window to guide the wandering spirits home through the darkness. We need not believe in the literal return of the dead to find in the traditions of this night some powerful and helpful metaphors. All cultures and all ages have struggled with the mystery of death and loss. The earliest recorded human story, the Epic of Gilgamesh from the Near East around 4,000 years ago, depicts the grief of its hero as the loss of his friend Enkidu. The first piece of music we heard tonight was part of Gilgamesh's lament. We heard it set to music by Karl Jenkins and performed in English and in Aramaic, the closest contemporary language to the original. In the second piece we heard, which was by the songwriter Martin Joseph, with words by Stuart Henderson, this perennial divine homesickness finds a haunting contemporary expression, because the desire for homecoming is eternal. The piece we'll hear before the intercession is another setting by Karl Jenkins of a poem of grief, this time by the 13th century Persian Sufi poet Jalaluddin Muhammad Rumi. When Rumi's great friend Shams al-Tabrizi mysteriously disappeared, Rumi mourned him in a series of passionate, ecstatic poems, such as the one we'll hear. So tonight we're going to take this opportunity to reflect on loss and recovery and on our readiness to welcome home the wanderer, the disowned, the forgotten, the mourned, and the beloved. We can call to mind the good things which we have received from loved ones now departed, and good aspects of our own lives which we have lost and would like to regain. So with that in mind, and with the Celtic connections of this night in mind, here is an invocation in English and in Welsh, written especially for this night of the year. It's a villanelle, and it's called Song for Samhain. The wall between the worlds grows thin when darkness falls on Samhain night. Open the door and let the dead come in. Fine as the filigree which spiders spin to hold the leaves of autumn in their flight, the wall between the worlds grows thin. Those who are safe past sanctity and sin, those who have gone the dark road to the light, open the dead, the door, and let the dead come in. Wind, as the keyhole cold upon the skin, shapes in the shadow, sheltered from the sight, the wall between the worlds grows thin. Love from our lost ones, kindness from our kin, prayers that we pray and blessings we recite, open the door and let the dead come in. Now, let the season of the soul begin. Welcome the wanderers who return tonight. The wall between the worlds grows thin. Open the door and let the dead come in. Tena, your mir, synchani beir agod ar galan geia, pan mae'r nos yn ddi, agor drws agar di ar leir yn ddod. Fel llinyn arian gwein pricoc di nod, a ddalian y ddael y hydref megis pri, tenau yw'r mir sy'n rhannu beth a bod. Y rhai sy'n diogel heibio gwarth a chlod, a deithio ffordd y gwyll i'r golau fri, agor y drws a gad i'r meil i ddod. Cwyn fan y gwynt wrth dwrth y clo a gwrdd, atgof o leisiau cerant gyda'i gri, tenau yw'r mir sy'n rhannu beth a bod. eilma diweno cariad colledu ddim cydnabod ni agor y drws y gad yn gwneud yn ddod. Ddoi a heddiw heno sy'n cydfod croeso i'r cwydriau da ychwelau llu tenau i'r mir sy'n rhannu bydd a bo agor y drws y gad yn gwneud yn ddod. So, let's take this night and this service to recall those good people, those good things we ourselves seem to have lost. Perhaps your delight and joy, your passion, your hope or ambition, your unquestioning trust, your sense of utter security, the love your lost ones had for you, whatever those things may be, recall them. Because no good thing is really lost. Those gifts can still serve you, can still inspire, and can still touch and help and heal others through you. All these qualities are held in God, so they are here now. And of course, it is not merely the gentle and pleasant things that bless and heal. Apparently unwelcome experiences can do so too, if they are met with faith and goodwill. Here is another poem by Rumi. It's called The Guest House. This being human is a guest house. Every morning a new arrival, a joy, a depression, a meanness, some momentary awareness comes as an unexpected visitor. Welcome and entertain them all, even if they're a crowd of sorrows who violently sweep your house empty of its furniture, still treat each guest honorably. He may be clearing you out for some new delight. The dark thought, the shame, the malice, meet them at the door laughing and invite them in. Be grateful for whoever comes, because each has been sent as a guide from beyond. So Rumi saw those challenging presences where both external and internal parts of ourselves we could acknowledge, welcome in and bring into the light of the warmth. Such an honest recognition can be transformative. With that in mind, here is another invocation from the great English poet, Kathleen Ray, a great mystical poet who died in 2003. So we can use this poem to invoke all the things in our experience that are lost, unacknowledged, forgotten, suppressed, and unwanted, but which, if we admit their troubling, disturbing, and frightening presence, may have the power to transform us. The poem is Northumbrian Sequence 4. Let in the wind, let in the rain, let in the moors tonight. The storm beats on my window pane, night stands at my bedfoot. Let in the fear, let in the pain, let in the trees that toss and groan, let in the north tonight. Let in the nameless, formless power that beats upon my door. Let in the ice, let in the snow, the banshee howling on the moor, the bracken bush on the bleak hillside. Let in the day tonight. The whistling ghost behind the dike, the dead that rot in mire. Let in the thronging ancestors, the unfulfilled desire. Let in the wraith of the dead earl. Let in the unborn tonight. Let in the cold. Let in the wet. Let in the loneliness. Let in the quick. Let in the dead. Let in the unpeopled skies. Oh, how can virgin fingers weave a covering for the void? How can my fearful heart conceive gigantic solitude? How can a house so small contain a company so great? Let in the dark, let in the dead, let in your love tonight. Let in the snow that numbs the grave, let in the acorn tree, the mountain stream and mountain stone, let in the bitter sea. Fearful is my virgin heart and frail my virgin form. And must I then take pity on the raging of the storm that rose up from the great abyss before the earth was made, that pause the stars in cataracts and shakes this violent world. Let in fire, let in the power, let in the invading light. Gentle must my fingers be, and pitiful my heart, since I must bind in human form a living power so great, a living impulse, great and wild, that cries about my house with all the violence of desire, desiring this my peace. And pitiful my heart must hold the lonely stars at rest, have pity on the raven's cry, the torrent and the eagle's wing, the icy water of the tarn, and on the biting blast. Let in the wound, let in the pain, let in your child tonight. Now, in the rest of tonight's service, there will be three more pieces of music. At the intermission, we'll hear Mystery by Bruce Coburn, which acknowledges the unknowable nature of the divine, to whose presence we bring all our losses and desires. At the consecration, we'll hear a piece by Gavin Bryars, which came about in an unusual way. Well, Bryars was recording a documentary about the homeless in London in 1971. He found he had accidentally recorded a snatch of a homeless man singing a gospel song. Bryars later looped it and set it to orchestral backing. It's called Jesus' Blood Never Failed Me Yet, and it's an evocative meditation on redemption, even in seemingly hopeless circumstances. And finally, at the dismissal, you'll have an 1887 gospel song by Anthony J. Shelter, recorded by Iris Dent, which tells of the divine welcome that awaits us all. So I began by saying that on this night it was a tradition to place a candle in the window to welcome home the wanderer. And I'll close with a poem which reminds us that the divine always has such a light in the darkness. It's by the Northern Irish poet Helen Waddell, who died in 1965. It reminds us that ultimately, however lost and battered and weary we are, like the wanderer we thought about at the beginning of this evening, there is, at last, someone waiting to welcome us home. The poem is called, I Shall Not Go to Heaven When I Die. I shall not go to heaven when I die, but if they let me be, I think I'll take the road I used to know that goes by Shir Nagara and the sea. And all day breasting me the wind shall blow, and I'll hear nothing but the peewits cry and the waves calling in the caves below. I think it will be winter when I die, for no one from the north could die in spring, and all the heather will be dead and grey, and the bog cotton will have blown away, and there will be no yellow on the wind. But I shall smell the peat, and when it's almost dark, I'll set my feet where a white track goes glimmering to the hills, and see, far up, a light. Would you think heaven could be so small a thing as a lit window on the hills at night? And come in, stumbling from the gloom, half blind into a firelit room, turn and see you, and there abide. If it were true, and if I thought that they would let me be, I almost wish it were tonight.
Join me in the affirmation of faith, which is in the Amen. We believe in God above us, maker and sustainer of all life, of sun and moon, of water and earth, of male and female. We believe in God of silence, Jesus Christ, the Word of flesh.
Let's pray.
Father of life, we come into this space tonight, remembering those that have departed, remembering those that have gone before us. We stand over their graves, their emblems surround us, their absence is felt in pain and joy of our memory, in words we've said and words that we never uttered. How can it be that a house this small holds a company so large? We are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. No, God, tonight we remember those in our families, those friends, those loved ones that have gone on, and we whisper their names even now, say their names even now. Remember these, O Lord, in your presence. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God, we remember tonight those that are standing over the hollow hole of grief and loss, for whom time has not healed wounds, has not given perspective. The loss of grief feels overwhelming and unbearable. We stand against a sea of darkness. The loss of children, parents, sons and daughters never to return from war. Those lost to the streets. Those unclaimed bodies, those that die in prison, and in back alleys, and in places all over this world that have no one to remember them. We, O God, tonight stand as a community of remembrance, and we remember. Collect their tears, O God. Hold them in a case around your own heart. We remember them. We remember the mothers and the fathers, those that have too much to bear tonight. Lord, in your mercy. In this thin space, Holy Spirit, would you remind us that we are just us? All the ways in which we deny the fact that this is all that there is, this moment, this present place, right now, God. Would you forgive us of all the ways that we deny our own death? All the ways that we create space between ourselves and others. All the ways that we compound and deny, push away the fact that all there is this thin veil between us and the departed. May we hold this present moment as a gift from your very Spirit, O Jesus. May you teach us how to number our days, so that we may live wisely and freely and dance and sing and mourn and cry and create poetry and community. But you, would you, O God, remember us? We pray this prayer in the name of Jesus, who taught us how to say, pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
confession. We'll use part B. Let us open our hearts to God and confess our failings to the one who knows all the secrets of our hearts and who has always loved us. Lord, forgive the times when we have failed to show love. Lord, forgive the times when we have deliberately done wrong. Lord, forgive the darkness within us and welcome us back into your light.
May God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit shine upon us, shine within us, and restore his image in us. Amen. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them the light has shined, to give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. In that day, declares the Lord, I will assemble the lame and gather the outcasts, even those whom I have afflicted. Let's stand together to declare who we are and what our peace is between one another. So we say together, we are God's children. We are made in his image. We are brothers and sisters together in the Lord Jesus Christ. We are one together through the power of the Holy Spirit. We live to love each other, to care and be compassionate to all. In this common strength, we share God's peace. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's offer one another a sign of that. Thank you.